So, welcome to the House of Sub-Hero. This is Peter. And,
this is Ritchie.
Special guest today, so...
First time ever on the show.
Good to have you here.
Nice to be here.
Yeah.
So, today we were watching Monty Python.
And the Holy Grail, yep. And so, you'd never seen this one before, Ritchie?
I never saw any of the Monty Pythons. I was a big fan of John Cleese beforehand. Saw him in a lot of movies. So I was interested to see him. And it was actually a lot of funny bits. Very random throughout the whole movie, yeah. But you keep focusing. And how many times you saw it now? About 10?
Yeah, well, maybe not 10, well, at least 5 anyway. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw this years ago when I was a kid and just found it one of the most hilariously funny movies I've ever seen. But
it's one of those movies that it is weird, but because it's old fashioned, it's still got funny bits in it. And like you're laughing the whole way through because it's unexpected. And there's a lot of like, kind of. Like, idiot bits but staffed and they're kind of laughing at the people.
You sort of have to like switch your mind off while you're doing this because there's stuff, if you think too much about it you'll just give yourself a headache, but yeah, it's because it's just so bizarrely funny.
And you're serious before the movie and then you go to watch it and the opening credits are a joke already, yeah. So and then at the end there's no credits, so they already...
Just a bit of organ music, yeah. So if you've not seen this, spoiler alert, but yeah, it's basically about King Arthur and the knights searching for the Holy Grail, in case you haven't worked that out, but it's a comedic spin on it.
So basically they're just taking the mickey out of all different parts of the movie,
you get
a comedy laugh out of it.
The knights split up and they do their different stuff, like Lancelot kills a whole load of people and Galahad gets seduced by some nuns.
So how did you feel about the actual acting side?
Oh, it's pretty good, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, with me and Gabriel, we're reviewing horror movies a lot, but yeah, and the acting in those is pretty terrible, so yeah.
Yeah.
This is a step up.
Yeah, they were good, because this came out, what, 74?
Yeah,
so
74.
So, you're nearly talking 40 years ago.
Yeah, the same time as the first series of Fawlty Towers.
Yeah.
That time, yeah. So yeah.
And that's another show you should be watching, Fawlty Towers.
Should be watching Fawlty Towers.
Great TV show.
Yeah. So, in case you're wondering where Gabriel is, he couldn't make it. We were going to do Alien today.
Yeah, but we're going to do it with the three of us, Alien. But since he couldn't make it, we thought, he can't do a horror genre. So we decided to mix it up a little.
Yeah, so from now on, there'll be like sort of different teams of hosts. Gabriel, Chris and I will be doing the horror movies. And me and Richie will probably be doing comedies. So it's a lot to look forward to.
And I've got my own channel at Richie S Official, so... If you want to take a look at that, and you can subscribe and comment and rate.
Yeah. So, guess we'll show you a clip now.
Yeah. So.
Okay, this is the Black Knight scene. You've got Graham Chapman as Arthur there, and the two knights fighting. It's really one of the. I mean, a lot of this is intelligently written, but this is one of the real slapstick scenes of the movie. Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's a.
One of the ones that you do laugh out loud and like, you're laughing the full way through the scene, really.
Yeah. So, yeah, you'll notice he's doing horse ride and mimes. But yeah, this relates back to a lot of Cleese on Fawlty Towers doing the Nazi walk, you know. It's a lot of the really.
This very over exaggerated, yeah.
Right, yeah. I think this movie probably had a really low budget, but it's amazing what they've done with it, you know?
Been very successful.
Yeah.
Even though it looks pretty low budget, but
yeah.
It's done well.
Yeah, I still think this must have been filmed in Scotland, because, yeah, it's just so...
Ah, yeah.
Here we go. Yeah, using tomato soup for gore. Old-fashioned.
Yeah, the old fake way.
Yeah. So this is the bridge scene, it's near the end of the film. It's
the best scene of all, in my opinion.
Yeah, it probably is. John Cleese there.
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is your favourite colour?
Blue.
Right, off you go.
There we go. That's all you need, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
But yeah, it's really good. It's really bizarre how you come up with this stuff, you know? It's
Stop! Who approaches the bridge of death must answer me these questions three. The other side, he see.
Ask me the questions, Bridge Keeper.
Again, it's a kind of like, weird thing.
Yeah.
But it's like, very funny.
Is your quest to seek the Holy Grail?
Punchline.
What is the capital of Assyria?
I don't know that.
Yeah, we wanted to get all these lines in, so yeah, it's just a really bizarre scene, so yeah.
So that was really good. Yeah. So what do you make of the bridge clip?
Yeah, it's just funny. I was telling Ritchie about the bridge scene before, and yeah.
That was all I had heard of the movie, and in my head I was already laughing at it. And then when I watched it there, like, the guy was about 110, he looked. And he kept saying the same thing, and then he just randomly asked, what's your favourite colour?
So, it's cool how they all play different parts throughout the movie. Like, I mean, Graham Chapman...
But they play them all well.
Yeah, Graham Chapman just plays Arthur for the movie, but John Cleese shows up everywhere. So yeah,
But when I started watching it, like, I could already tell it was John Cleese, like, in his first scene.
Yeah.
But they're very versatile and they're really good actors.
Yeah, so yeah, you should check out the series, Monty Python's Flying Circus, and the three movies, Holy Grail, Life of Brian, and...
And I thought the scenery was really well done. We'll try to work out where it was. And
we think it was filmed in Scotland, probably.
Yeah. Well, it kind of looked like that because of like, the Highlands and that. But it was really nice scenery. And like the little animation parts, they were really well done.
Yeah. Terry Gilliam, the sixth member, he does all the animation. So
yeah.
He has like smaller roles. He plays the coconut guy.
So I'll need to take a look at the other two as well.
But, yeah. We'll probably get to those if we can.
Even though you've said that's the best one, those are still good.
The other two are pretty damn good as well. So, Ritchie, this question's almost superfluous, but Ritchie, do you recommend Monty Python and the Holy Grail?
I recommend it. I don't think, if you like comedy, say, or you like horror, and this is a kind of unusual kind of genre, it's hard to put it in, it's a kind of old-fashioned kind of comedy, but... You don't have to like unusual films, or you can just not have anything. You could like romantic comedy and then come in and watch this and love it. It's one of the movies that you need to be you don't have to be old-fashioned to watch it, but you put back your mind into a kind of old-fashioned sense. And some stuff's dry, some stuff's completely random. And would you recommend it to?
There is a bit of quote-unquote romance in the movie.
Yeah,
I do recommend it. Yeah, it's one of my favourite comedies. Maybe it's because I saw it when I was a kid, though. But
yeah,
I think it's just held up so well.
It's quite an unusual thing to see as a kid, I would imagine.
We'll be seeing you sometime in the future. We'll get to the other two movies, hopefully, and some other comedies.
So I hope you enjoyed us talking about Monty Python.
Yeah. And within the next, before Christmas, myself, Gabriel, and Chris plan to review Alien, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and Black Christmas. So, a lot of stuff coming your way, so we'll see you.
Take care. Bye.
Bye. Hi, this is Peter. Just to say that you can now like the show on Facebook at the House of Something or Other Facebook chat page. And also to say that, just to say thanks to everyone who's watched the show so far. And that we've got a lot of stuff coming. As I said, we'll be doing Alien, Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Black Christmas. But if you've got any other suggestions, we'd love to hear them. And we'll see you.